Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our second edition of 10 Questions With. Today, we're joined by our second team manager, Hugh Sneddon. I hope you're doing well, Hugh, in this troubled times and difficult times. Hope you and your family are good.
Yeah, we're doing all right, thank you. Yeah, it's nice to have some sunshine at last.
Right, I'll dive straight in and we'll go with question one. Some of our newer supporters, or those that have just followed the first team, might not know a lot about you. So if you can just give us a bit about yourself, your sort of personal life, your football life, etc.
Yeah, I'm 32 years old, or young, however you want to look at that. I've been married for 7 years to my wife, Laura. We've been together for 15 years. So a long time, childhood sweetheart, some might say. We have two children together and a lovely family home in Cotton. Two children, Hetty and Xander. Hetty's 2 years old, Xander is 4 months old. So busy spinning lots of plates at the moment, especially at home. Career, I work for Openreach, telephone engineer, auditor. So I do a lot of checks on contractors and loads of other boring stuff you don't really want to know about. But that's me outside of football. Football wise, my team is the mighty Glasgow Celtic. We don't care how we get the league this year, but we'll take it. My playing career, I played for Forward Amateurs. Was my last sort of club before I stepped into management. Before that, I was AFC Fylde and just predominantly Sunday League footballer. That sort of sums me up, really.
Excellent. So, question two. Initially, you came to Garstang with Simon Bentham as his number two. How did you sort of find the step up when Simon left to be a manager at what was a relatively young age?
Yeah, I was very fortunate, really, to... I mean, me and Simon are still very close friends, best mates even. Very, very fortunate to have him as my mentor. Take me under his wing and sort of give me an opportunity about actually knowing much about my sort of management coaching sort of style. He took a chance on me there and hopefully the club look and think he's paid dividends. Fingers crossed. Must be doing something right. I'm still here at least for now. When he sort of went on to Pastures New, I took it with both hands. It was an opportunity I couldn't turn down. I fell in love with the club straight away, fell in love with the lads, and I really relished the opportunity of sort of trying to lead that, the sort of head man, and see what the difference was. I mean, I think in some aspects it's probably easier being a number two, because you don't have to sort of be the cutthroat guy, but you can sort of like... help steer the head guy to make them sort of decisions. So it's a little bit, your management skills definitely get tested as you step up. And I think we were quite fortunate in the first year. I had inherited such a great squad from Simon with a couple of little tweaks of my own. But, I relished it, to be honest. It's good.
Excellent. With the first team now in the Northwest Counties, the second team obviously moved from the West Lancs Reserve League into Division 2, where you face other first teams. How has that been?
That's a test. It's tough. It's tough for a number of reasons, really. One, the first team, like you just mentioned, and we're the second team. So, sort of like... the onus of what the club's trying to achieve sort of goes by the first team and the drive, and that's not taking anything away from the club. That's just the way it is. You get that as a reserve side, if you will. But also the teams we're playing are first teams, so they will be training 2-3 times a week. The churn of the core squad is not like ours, so we've got the youth team coming in. And then we've got players going on to our first team or onto different clubs or whatever. So it is difficult to sort of keep that core and build on it when you're branded as a sort of reserve side. And it's also mentally, I think, for some of the players. My player, if you ask any of my players, they'll tell you straight away, I mentioned it quite a lot, we're playing first teams. We have to act as a first team. You have to have the mental mindset of being a first team. If you don't, and you don't have that sort of passion, desire, sort of lion heart way of playing, then you will get bullied off the pitch at times. And I'm not saying let's go out and be ferocious and, you know, that we have game plans. I like us to play the modern game, if you will, modern football, and sort of like football teams off the park, if we can. But there has to be that element of a bit of grit, especially against first team. So you could take, for example, Stories out of our league. You know, they've come into the league this season, probably been together for quite some time. And you can tell that by the style of the play and how tough they are to sort of break down. I think that sort of is quite a good example.
Yeah, and obviously the start of this season must have been particularly difficult for you, with several of your key squad going into the first team and your first seven league matches all away from the Riverside, with a few trips to Barra thrown in the mix.
Yeah, you could say that, yeah. It certainly was difficult. Tried to take the positives out of it, that we were going to get all the Barra trips out of the way at the beginning. Hopeful for some home games to follow, but it seemed to be lots and lots of away games backing up. Four was in the Lakes. We had a couple of midweek games thrown in the middle of that, which we didn't particularly turn up to. Lads working, lots of festivals on, weddings, you know, lots of summer events going on around that time of year in August. And there was also the added factor of losing, I think it was five, maybe six players to the first team to sort of help bolster their squad at the beginning of the season. So it was almost, by the time we got to September, it was like a rebuild process again. It was almost like a pre-season for me. Trying to get players in September is very difficult to when people start settling down in the clubs at that time.
Yeah, and obviously some of the players returned from the first team squad, but they were victims, for want of a better word, of the 21-day rule, which realistically is a 28-day rule. So it stops lads from sort of playing for a month. How did you, and more importantly, the lads, cope with that?
Yeah, that it's tough. It's tough to manage, really, because you've got a lad who might go and play 5 minutes for five games for the first team, and not really be able to sort of showcase himself. And then he has to have, you say 21 days, but you alluded to it, effectively it's 28 days because it's Saturday to Saturday. So it has to be the following week. So it's almost 28 days. That's tough to sort of keep someone motivated, keep them fit, keep them interested, and more importantly, keep them at the club, because the lads just want to play football at the end of the day. And to say to him, listen, thanks for going with the first team for 5 minutes the other week, but now you can't play for a month. Not going to be too happy, really. So it's tough. I mean, from a personal point of view, I have to do the best I can on the training field is the most I can do. I can sort of put my arm around them and you know, give them the niceties and try and keep them involved and active. But the reality is, he's 28 days off the field. So, and as we've all realised at these times, it's tough.
So, before the season ended, last five games, you'd won three, drawn one, lost one, which was sort of a big improvement in form. Saw you sort of pull away from the wrong end of the table. Were you pleased with the turnaround post Christmas?
Definitely, yeah. Yeah, definitely. So going back a question, really, as well, sort of helps that. So we lost five or six players to the first team. A couple of them actually went to different clubs because they didn't want to wait 28 days. Sort of wanted to get back in, sort of like make themselves in like going to say about the first team before. A couple of them want to go and play a first team football elsewhere, rather than dropping back down to the sort of second team of Garstang. And then we by the time they've had their 28 days, we then had issues with the weather, which sort of, I thought Noel was going to turn up on his arc at one point. Basically we then started to, on the training field, we rebuilt and rebuilt and rebuilt and worked on systems and the way we wanted to play. And it gave me time as a coach to sort of implement step change within the field of play, so and how we're going to deliver these systems. And that started to see that straight after Christmas. Like you say, three wins and a draw and a loss. But you could definitely see, especially in the mentality, change of the players. So, yeah, it was positive. It's a shame we didn't get a chance to push on. We had 10, maybe 11 games left. So it's a shame we didn't get a chance to sort of showcase ourselves as a squad, really.
You took over the manager's role at the start of the 2017 season. There have been lots of ups and downs in that time. Tell us of a sort of a low point during your tenure.
For me, probably a low point was last season going into the second division, even though it was like a promotion for us. I'd say about halfway through the season, maybe October, November, understanding from my point of view, the understanding that we were playing against the first teams and how to try and keep my team motivated. And I felt I kind of took that personally, that I wasn't giving my players the best chance or giving them the best sort of advice and stuff like that, which sounded off a couple of players and sort of just to see whether or not they sort of felt that way from me and whether I was doing the right thing for the team, because you only want to do the right thing for the lads, to make sure that the most important thing is that they're enjoying the football. So that for me, I found quite hard from a coach's perspective. That will probably be my lowest, to be honest.
Okay, well, if we flip that on its head then, what about your sort of high point?
Well, the first season, really. I couldn't have even, I had to pinch myself a few times. I thought I was dreaming. I couldn't even have imagined. I think we went something like 17 games unbeaten. And it was just like, a dream, but what I did find in that season was when we did get beat, I learned more from one loss than I did from any of the wins, because as a win you just keep going, you keep going with the same sort of mentality, the momentum sort of takes you through, but that one loss it sort of really hits home and you think, you know what, I've really learned there. So that first season we won the league and the cup double, and that was amazing. And I mean, I still see the photographs from time to time, and it still brings back loads of good memories and what a good team we had. And it's good to see some of them players now playing at higher levels. It's really good. So
obviously you alluded this in your end of season speech. How important are the youth team during your time here? And are there any prospects in there, any names we need to be looking out for?
The youth team are very important. I hope they feel that I give them that sort of level as well. I'm always talking with Simon, who's been a fantastic help to me this season for the reserves, and also hopefully I've helped him back a little bit with the youth team. But yeah, they're extremely important. Throughout the time I've been here, we've had lots of youth players come through. Some really good and excelled and pushed on. For example, Cam Ross, you know, just one of a number. And then there's the other ones that come through and don't quite make the grade, which is a tough cut, really, because again, the lads just want to come and play and enjoy football. But yeah, it's really important, I feel, for the confidence, the morale, the development of the young players of the game to sort of make that step into sort of adult football. And you've got to take into consideration that these lads are 16, 17 years old and they're still changing. The minds are changing, the physique's changing. So you've got to take all that into consideration. But we've seen, you think we've had something like 7 youth players involved this year within the first within the reserves team. And I would say probably 4 on a regular basis, week in, week out, have been involved. He's no longer with the youth setup, but Charlie Powers is definitely one to keep an eye on next season for the reserves. But coming through, you've got the likes of Bryden, the goalkeeper, Danny Corliss, Lewis Heap, Matt Hardman, all really good players. And probably a few that I've not mentioned there, your Cows, Ollies, Owens, you know. So it's good to sort of see these players develop. You know, I remember some of these players just turning up for the first session, seeing where they are now. It's it's leaps and bounds ahead of where they were. So it's good. That's really good.
Excellent.
That just makes it, you know, gives you satisfaction really as a coach.
Mm-hmm. Right, and question number 10. Tell us about your favourite footballing memory and why. And this doesn't have to be relating to Garstang.
I'll give you one from Garstang. And I'll give you one from out. So, Garstang, favourite memory. On the pitch, I would say we played Swarthmore away. We went with a few players, and I had to play. You knew I was gonna say it. I had to play, sort of an hat trick. And I think I should have just left it there rather than doing a few cameos since. But yeah, that's definitely a good point. But it's definitely topped off by the season 2017-18 season when we won the cup and league double. That for me just unbeatable. And outside, not so much one instance, but going to watch the football with my dad, going up to watch Celtic. It doesn't matter if we're playing Inverness or we're playing Valencia. As long as I'm there with my dad, it's always a great, enjoyable experience.
Brilliant. Thank you very much for your time, Hugh. And hope to see you back once the season starts.
See you soon. Take care.